Is Wall Street all out of love with crypto? Bitcoin fell almost 6% today and reports Goldman Sachs decided to break up with their Bitcoin trading plans. Bob Pisani's at the NYSE with more. Hi, Bob.
I'm just here for the music. Love it. It was one of the big rumors that helped fuel Bitcoin at its height last year that Goldman Sachs was looking to launch a crypto trading desk. Then CEO Lloyd Blankfein tweeted about that time that it was still thinking about doing something on Bitcoin, but nothing happened. And now a report from Business Insider says Goldman is shelving those plans due to regulatory concerns and Bitcoin is falling in response. Goldman refused to confirm or deny the report, but they did issue this statement. In response to client interest in various digital products, we are exploring how best to serve them in this space. At this point, we have not reached a conclusion on the scope of our digital asset offering. While Goldman never really acted on its plans, Bitcoin bulls have been pitting their hopes for a rally this year on two developments. First, that an institutional investor like Goldman would come into the space to drive additional demand. And second, that a Bitcoin ETF might be approved by the SEC. Now, neither of those have happened, and the lack of those catalysts will likely make it a lot more difficult for Bitcoin to move significantly, at least in the short term. Finally, Melissa, I can't help but notice the Canopy growth. We talked about it the other day. One of the largest pot stocks hit another new high today, more than doubling in just the last 3 weeks. Seems like pot stocks have replaced crypto as the new fast money trade. Back to you, Melissa.
All right, Bob. Thanks. Bob Pisani at the NYSE. So does this all mean that Wall Street is over Bitcoin and our Bitcoin's best days behind it? Let's bring in the man who says the crypto universe could be worth $10 trillion, RBC analyst Mitch Steves. Mitch, great to have you with us.
Thanks for having me.
You know, the move by Goldman seems to underscore the fear that perhaps institutional investors have cold feet about Bitcoin because of the regulatory issues. I mean, should this be a concern for Bitcoin investors?
So I don't think it's a really big concern. So first of all, the institutional investors that I speak with that have been involved for the last 5 years or so, they're still involved in the space and still track it very closely. So what I think Goldman is having a hard time with is they can't really find a way to get institutional investors to invest. So specifically, they are invested in Circle, which is essentially a competitor to Coinbase, right? So they're already able to get trading flows in the retail side, but the institutional side is very difficult. And so I think what they're realizing now is probably the next step to get institutional money. They're kind of waiting now for a Bitcoin ETF to get approved.
You first came on this show, Mitch, with your initial report, and that was saying that Bitcoin, the ecosystem, could be $1 trillion. Have you pared that back at all? Have you adjusted that given the developments that we've seen in Bitcoin and given the price fluctuations we've seen?
No, I mean, it really doesn't change it. So again, I'll make the same comment I made earlier, which is you can't really look at this from a year-to-year basis, even though I know it gets a lot of traction if you do it that way, because basically it's like a venture capital investment where you're looking at 10 to 15 years, right? So, but if you really wanted to look at the near-term dynamics and why the trading's been negative this year, I would say what you're really waiting for is really two things in the next 6 to 9 months. I think what you're looking for is an ETF to get approved. Mm-hmm. I think in order for an ETF to get approved, you need to own the underlying Bitcoin. The last 9 ETFs that were denied actually didn't own any Bitcoin, and they were based on future pricings, like a gold ETN. And then secondly, I think there's still actually one more negative thing that needs to happen, which is I think all the funds that raised money in Q4 of last year at the highs for a cryptocurrency hedge fund, they'll probably start shutting down. So I think those are the two things you're probably looking at near term. But if we look at it from a technical perspective, Everything is still tracking ahead of plan.
All right, Mitch, we've got to keep it short tonight. Thanks so much for your time. Appreciate it. Always good to see you. Mitch Steves of RBC. Pete, what's your trade?
You know, Mitch talks about the 5 to 10 year plan, and that's what we've heard a lot from a lot of the folks in this whole crypto world. So I think that's something that has to be kept in mind. I think if you're looking more short term, I like some of the plays outside of it, the secondary plays, AMD, for example, NVIDIA. AMD has been flying, and we've been watching it for the last couple of days.